Good morning, Shreya. Just wait for other students to join in. In 5 minutes, we'll start the session.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. Ma'am, how many students are there in GRE?
There are approximately 5 students.
Okay, okay, ma'am.
Shreya, I'm just starting the lecture right now, and whatever I've told you in the previous lecture, I'll just open up the slides so that you can just have a quick rundown on those slides, and we'll start with the practice test today.
Okay, ma'am.
If you don't get anything, just ask me the question in these slides, okay? For 5-10 minutes, we'll definitely play these slides. Or if you want, I can start the lecture from the very beginning. Do you remember the last slides which we have done about parallelism?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so just have a quick rundown on this. Okay, so now if you have read all these concepts again, which we have discussed in the earlier lecture, I will start with the practice part of parallelism today. In parallelism, you'll get the advanced level question, but for understanding those advanced level questions, you need to start from a very basic level. All right, and I have displayed a question in front of you. If you can see, the question itself says, identify the part having an error. So I have told you the concepts of parallel structure, parallel comparisons, the difference between like and as, the difference between not only, but also what kind of sentences you have to make in English while checking out the error, right? So in these options, you will get some of the options like A, B, C, D, no error. And there will be options in A, B, C, D in the form of sentences. You have to tell that which sentence is wrongly done. So I will solve one question for you, all right? And the remaining questions, for the remaining questions, I will give you 2 minutes to solve, and then we can discuss those questions in our lecture, all right? So how to solve these questions? Basically, the question here itself says in the A option, engines used in space shuttle are. Now here you can see that engines is a plural subject and are is a plural verb. So I think plural subject has the plural verb. So I think this is particularly correct as a sentence. Much larger and much larger. Larger is the second form of verb. More strong than, more strong. Again, they're using adjective and they're making a comparison because they are using the word than for comparison. The ones used in jet planes. The ones means they're talking about the engines which are used in jet planes. All right. So A and D are perfectly okay. There are no problems. But in B and C options, you can see in B option, they have used the word larger. So definitely if they're using the second form of verb, in C option also, we need to use the second form of verbs to make a parallel structure. So if we are using the word larger, it should be stronger in C option, not more strong. Okay, then it will be a parallel structure. So the exact sentence will be, engines used in space shuttles are much larger and stronger than the ones used in jet planes. So the answer here, which has an error, is the C option. So C will be our correct answer. This is how you need to identify the correct sentences. I think in your childhood also, you have done the omitting part. Omitting or editing, right? So the omitting part is like you have to omit, you have to find out the error in a particular sentence. So this is how you will find an error in the C option. So the answer will be C here, right? So in the same way, we'll do certain exercises of English language, which will definitely help you in CAT and GRE examination, because English definitely contains more marks, like 76 marks. Out of 76 marks, you can say 32 marks are for English. So you need to be very aware about the parallelism structure, because you'll be able to get, you know, 8 to 9 mark question in your final examination, right? So I'll give you another question. You can just check it out. Here the sentence says, I'll speak for you. Sentence below has been divided into 4 parts. Identify the part having an error. If no part has an error, like if you find no error in the particular sentence, either in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so the answer will be 5th, no error. Okay. So here the question says, some insects bear a remarkable resemblance to dead twigs, being long, slenderness, wing length, and brownish in color. And 5th is no error. So to find out which sentence is wrong, so you'll be given 2 minutes time, because you'll get this much time in your final exam to solve. Okay. So just try solving it and then we'll find the answer. Did you find the answer, Shreya? Okay, so let's start the discussion of this question. And what was the answer here? So Shreya, did you find any answer that which one will be having an error? Okay, I'll explain this question and then we'll do further exercises. First one says some insects. Insects is a plural subject. Bear a remarkable resemblance to dead twigs. So they are just talking about dead twigs. So there is no plural verb in this particular case. They are using the word bear here for as a plural verb. That is perfectly okay. They are not just extending the sentence. Some insects bear a remarkable resemblance to dead twigs. Resemblance to is correct. It's a parallel structure to dead twigs. And they're using a preposition. So dead twigs is written in a very correct way. So the first one is correct. This is not the answer. Being long, slenderness, wingless, and brownish in color, no error. Now this question has an error in certain sentences because here they are using the word dead twigs as a noun because they're talking about a specific kind of species of insects. Dead twigs, they have something. So here they are using an adjective long, slenderness, winglets, and brownish in color. They are using some adjectives in this particular sentence. So here the usage of being is incorrect because they are just referring this adjective to this particular noun. So there is no need to write being here because being long may be correct, but being slenderness, being wingless does not make sense in a sentence. And this being refers to all the characteristics of adjectives which they are talking about the dead twigs. So that's why being will not be the answer. All right, this is a specific funda. If you're using an adjective, every sentence must have an adjective to complete the sentence. And all those adjectives should refer to one noun, right? So if all those adjectives have to refer to one noun, so being word will not go with every sentence or every word. So that's why we will eliminate this. Answer will be second. Okay, so in particular column of CAT exam, there will be a column of an answer. You have to write two as an answer. Then only it will be correct. And these are called theta-based questions. Type in the answer. And for this, you will have no negative marking. Right? There will be no negative marking in this case. All right. So let's go to another question now. These are just beginner level questions. We'll definitely focus from the beginner level to the advanced level of questions. All right. So I'm giving you 2 minutes time more to solve this question. This is a very easy question, but yes, there is a trick in solving this question. As the question says, the sentence below has been divided into four parts. Identify the part having an error. If there's no part which has an error, you have to mark that. And the question says, the question here is not of autonomy, but devolution of power to grassroots level. No error. Now you'll get 2 minutes time to solve this. All right. So let's start with this question now. Now in this question itself, it's saying, the question here is not of autonomy, but devolution of power to grassroots level. Now autonomy is something which is related to liberty, independence. And they are using the word of here as a preposition by depicting this word autonomy. That the question here is not of autonomy, but devolution of. So if you can see here, the word autonomy is a noun. Right? And if we talk about the word devolution here, so it is also a noun. If we are using that here, the question is not of autonomy. We are using the word, you can say we are using the preposition here before the noun. So definitely after but also, like this word also, you need to use the preposition before the noun. Because this is the correct usage of preposition and noun verbs, right? So preposition with noun makes sense in a sentence, but we will not write devolution of. We will write but of devolution power to a grassroots level. This is called a power, devolution power to a grassroots level. So of here is a preposition which should be written before the noun. So here the correct error in a particular sentence is in third, right? So this was the answer. Let's solve another question now. Try solving this. Shreya, in this question, you need to tell me the error exactly. Shreya, have you found the error in this sentence? Okay, I will tell you the answer for this. First of all, just analyze the question. I love reading books. This is perfectly okay. We always say that in our hobbies, I love reading books. Okay, so this sentence is particularly fine. So it's not having an error. We will eliminate this question or this option, which is a good habit. Now here, they are just mentioning that if I love reading books, this is a good habit. This is called a non-essential information. If I love reading books, it's a good habit. Everybody knows. So this is something which I should not tell them in a sentence because unnecessarily we are giving us extra information. All right. And is perfectly okay because they're using a sentence and they are just referring to the other sentence, which is a different one. And you can see here they are using which should be followed. Should is for suggestion. So the earlier sentence was not parallel to this sentence because earlier sentence says which is a good habit, which should be followed. So this is a statement and this is a suggestion. So it's not a parallel structure, we can say. So we have to change one thing here. Now in second option, which is a good habit, there is no such grammar error in this particular sentence. Otherwise this is correct, but this is an extra information. But the grammar error here will be in the third option. Because here, which is not the correct word to write it here. It should be it. Because they are referring to reading books. They're talking about the reading part. That reading should be followed by all. They're not talking about the habit should be followed. They're talking about reading should be followed. Reading is a good habit. Okay. So that is like here, this is a noun. So we have to use the pronoun to depict that particular sentence. I'll give you one example that how I found this error. Suppose if I'll say my car, which has red tires, got punctured. Right. So now here, my car, which has red tires, got punctured. Ultimately, I want to say to you is my car got punctured. All right. But here, which has red tires is something which is non-essential information. If I have eliminated this word or this sentence from this sentence, definitely it makes sense. I'm actually saying that my car got punctured. So there is no need for this sentence. Similarly, in this second option, this sentence is non-essential. But yes, if they are using it, that is not incorrect. That's also correct. But here, the pronoun should be used because this is referring to books. That's why the error here will be in the third option. So this is how you will identify grammar errors in a particular sentence. Now let's solve another question. This one. Now this is an intermediate level question. Just a second. This is an intermediate level question. Do it carefully because ultimately you'll get the advanced level question in CAT GRE examination, right? For that, you need to go through these levels to identify the correct things. Now here, just read the statement very carefully. It is saying, in each question, there are these four sentences. Identify the sentences that is correct in terms of grammar. Now, earlier, what we were doing, we were marking the error sentences. Right, but here you don't have to mark the errors. You have to write the accurate sentence because there will be errors in three sentences maybe or two sentences. Okay, so I have to find the correct one. So we'll get 2 minutes time to solve this question and then we will start discussing. This is a very interesting question. If you'll do it carefully. Okay, let's solve this question now. I will make you understand this very carefully because these kind of concepts will definitely help you in solving the other questions or the rest of the questions, right? This is very interesting. Now, let's start with the very first option here. A option says, every day I watch many TV channels, perfectly okay, including those which are popular and which are not popular. This is a parallel structure. Clearly, it's shown in this sentence that they're talking about there are TV channels, including those which are popular, 50% are popular and 50% are not popular. So this is a parallel structure they're talking about, right? So there's no such error in the very first sentence. But let's check out the B option here. The popularity of football is more than cricket. I have told you in the previous slides also, if we are talking about the football's popularity, then it will be compared to the cricket's popularity. Right? If we are talking about the popularity of football, it should be compared to the popularity of the cricket. Right? So if we have to make a sentence, a correct sentence, it should be the popularity of football is more than the popularity of cricket. Just as the A option. It is written which are popular and which are not popular. So these are parallel structures. Same in the case of popularity of football is more than popularity of cricket. So then it will be a parallel structure, right? So if the A is correct, B will not be correct because this is a wrong sentence. They are just matching the popularity with cricket, not the cricket's popularity. So I'll write it here, right? Okay. So this is a wrong sentence. We know that B is eliminated. Let's check out the C option now. C option says, Sachin played in the test series against Australia. So it is perfectly fine. Sachin played test series against Australia. Okay. Tenaciously. Okay. This is an adverb. Tactfully, an adverb. With patience. Now, patience is not at all an adverb. So basically, if we have referred to the patience word here, patience is a noun. So how can we write it parallelly if we are talking about an adverb that Sachin played tenaciously, tactfully means strategically and strongly. So it should be patiently to make it to adverb. We can't use the noun here. So this will be a correct sentence if we'll write patiently here. Otherwise, this sentence is a wrong sentence. All right. All right. Let's check out the last option here. D option says, I prefer to listen to those who speak honestly. Okay, adverb is used. The words with ly at last are called adverbs. Like if we're talking about the word gradual here. Gradual is an adjective. But if we put ly gradually, it will become an adverb. The usages are different. That's why we write it like this. So if the word is honestly, this will be an adverb. All right. So if it is written, I prefer to listen to those who speak honestly. Okay. To those who are dishonest. Again, this is wrong, because honestly, if we are writing an adverb, so dishonest, what does dishonest means? It means we are writing an adjective. We have to convert it to adverb to make a parallel structure. So it should be to those who speak, sorry, who don't speak, because they're talking about dishonest, huh? Who don't speak honestly. Right? Because the word to those is used, that's why we have to write it in parallel structure. Just in the case of A option, if you can see, which are popular, which are not popular. Here also, who speak honestly, who don't speak honestly. So this should be parallel. So that's why D option is also eliminated. So the correct option in terms of grammar and usage will be A only, A option. Okay, because in the rest of the options, there's a problem of noun. So in some cases, there's a problem of adjective. There's a problem of adverb. So that's why you have to make the parallel structure. Okay, I hope this is very much clear to you. Let's check out the another question. This is the question. Now solve it. It's just like the same. The concepts are different. Otherwise, you'll find the same kind of sentences here also. Start doing it for 2 minutes. Okay, so let's try solving this very question. Here, there are 4 options. You have to find the correct in terms of grammars and usage. So let's check out the very first option here. Anija likes reading novels. Okay, they're talking about reading novels. That means they're using verbs first form plus ing. Playing badminton, they're using verbs first form plus ing. And to listen to music. Now here the sentence is changed. Here only the first form is used with to, which is a wrong structure. This is not a parallel structure. If we have to make a parallel structure, we have to write a sentence like Anija likes reading novels, playing badminton and listening to music. Okay, so it should not be to listen. It should be listening to music. Then only we can say it's a parallel structure. So definitely there's an error in A option. We will eliminate this option. Okay. Now let's check out this second option. The distance from Bangalore to Kochi is greater than Bangalore to Chennai. Now, in the earlier question, I have told you about the popularity of football is compared to the popularity of cricket. Right? That's why the sentence was wrong. Same in the case of this question. The distance from Bangalore to Kochi is greater than, not from Bangalore to Chennai, but is greater than the distance from Bangalore to Chennai. We have to compare the distance with that of the distance, not to the cities. Okay. So here, the sentence should be, the correct sentence should be, the distance from Bangalore to Kochi is greater than the distance of Bangalore to Chennai. All right. So here, V option is also eliminated because of non-parallel structure. Let's come up to the C option, which is somewhat like the option which will come in advanced level questions. So the C option says, new economic regulations implemented. So they are using the plural subject. They're using the plural verb. In our country, facilitated OCBs to invest in stocks, start businesses and export goods and services. Now you can see here, they are talking about all the verbs. To invest, verb. To start, verb. To export, verb. Now you can see all the structure is parallel. They are talking about investment in stocks, so they have used the verb invest. They are talking about starting the business, they have used the verb start. They are talking about exporting goods and services, they have used the verb export. Everything is parallel. C is perfectly fine in terms of sentence. All right. Let's check out the D option now. The number of employees working in company X is higher than employees working in company Y. Now here, again, the problem is like popularity of football and cricket. They're talking about the number of employees working in company X is higher than the number of employees working in company Y. So they are comparing the number with the employees. They are not, they should not compare it because this is not a correct comparison. The correct comparison is that if we are comparing X and Y companies, employees number with each other, that should be correct. So in this case, D will also be eliminated because that's wrong. All right. So out of all these options, the correct answer is C only. I hope you are getting it, all the concepts of verbs, noun, adjectives and adverbs, because this is the very important concept which will help you out in further life also if you want to become something in English department. All right. So this will be perfectly fine. Right. Let's solve another question now. This is the advanced level question which will appear in your GRE and CAT examination. Just try solving that. And definitely, if you'll not be able to solve it, I will help you out. Shreya, am I clear? Shreya, are you getting the concepts? Okay, let's start solving this question. This was not a very tough question, but yes, there was a trick in this question. So let's find out that trick, and it will help you out in the next questions as well. Now, this will come in your CAT GR examination. You will be given a sentence and there will be four to five lines. You have to check out that which grammatical aspect is incorrect in this sentence. You need to mark that. You have to find out the correct sentence in terms of grammar and its usage. Now, the question here says, with companies spending large parts of their advertising budgets online, the market for content such as feature articles, opinion essays, created by a professional writer, a blogger, these are different individuals, and by individual users, are expanding rapidly. Now, you can see here, this here, such as, after the word such as, this sentence is non-essential, because if they're talking about such as feature articles and opinion essays, we don't want to know about this thing that who created it. So the opinion essays and articles are created by three people, a writer, a blogger, and users. All right. So if there will be no such information in this sentence, then also it will be okay. So this is a non-essential information. But yes, they're talking about feature articles and opinion essays. This is an example, because they're using in words such as here, all right? But here, if you can check out this helping verb are, this are refers to the market, because here the sentence changes. The market for content such as, so this particular line after such as is related to the content, but what is expanding rapidly? That is the market. This is something which is expanding rapidly. So now you can see if the market is a singular subject, we have to use a singular verb. So R is wrong here. So whatever sentences which has R in it are eliminated. So you can eliminate the first option. You can. With the third option and the fifth option. Let's check out how these sentences are different. Now here the sentence says the market for content such as a feature articles and opinion essays. Now this article a here means to one particular thing. And you can see they're talking about the feature articles. This is plural. So this can't be one single articles. So here the usage of a is incorrect. All right. So ultimately the answer will be fifth. And the sentence says the market for content such as feature articles, that is perfectly okay. Opinion essays created by professional writers, bloggers, and individual users is expanding. So this will be perfectly fine, because these are created by professional writers, bloggers. So that differently means different, that we don't have to write by a professional or blogger. These essays and articles are not written by one writer or one blogger or one user. They are written by multiple users, multiple bloggers, multiple professional writers. So we can't specify the word a here. That's why this is the wrong sentence, and the correct sentence will be fifth. Now in your final answer, these are the theta based questions. So you will get no negative marking if you'll find the wrong answer, but you need to find the correct answers to score 3+ marks. For one question, you will get 3 scores. All right. So this is very important. And these kind of questions will come in your CAT exam. All right. So let's solve such questions, more such questions. Let's solve this one. So I'm giving you 2 minutes time to solve this.
Ma'am, the question is not visible.
Sorry? Is the question visible now?
No, ma'am.
The question is not visible. Now just check out.
Ma'am, the previous question is on screen.
Previous question? Did you get it now? This is the unbiased third party clean teams. Is it visible now? Shreya, it is visible now. Just can you please confirm it to me?
Now it is visible now.
All right. Okay, let's start doing it. Shreya, have you found the answer?
No, ma'am.
It's very easy if you can find this. You can see the parallel structure here is assessing, helping, and here is support. So what are the options which can be eliminated here?
First and fourth.
First and fourth will be the correct answers or the wrong answers?
Correct answers.
Yeah, first and fourth. Huh, na? But out of these two also, there is only one correct. Which one is it? So we'll have to read this sentence very carefully to find that answer. Because it is saying unbiased third-party clean teams can protect sensitive data while assessing the business rationale of a deal. This is a one aspect where they have used the verbs first form plus ing. Helping to develop an integrated business plan. This is also verb first form plus ing. So ultimately, it should be supporting negotiations. All right, verb first form plus ing. That means the first answer and the fourth answer has supporting. All right. Correct. So we'll find that answer very easily because here it is written to support the, which is wrong. Supported relevant verbs third form, that is particularly wrong. And support verbs first form, that's also wrong. Now let's check out the first option first. While assessing the business rationale of a deal, helping to develop an integrated business plan and supporting. So there is no such change. Only supporting is changed. Otherwise, this whole sentence is perfectly okay as compared. They have just added a new word, facilitating, which is not required, I think. Facilitating the assessment of a business rationale, help to develop. Here, the verb is changed. It has been converted into verb first form. That is unnecessary. We don't have to change the verb because the verb was perfectly okay. All right. And they have written the word supporting here, which is not required then because the whole sentence is purely changed. So the fourth option is also incorrect. In this case, the answer will be answer number one, which is correct. All right. Because we have to use the parallel structure. So ultimately the verb first form plus ing should be used in every after every comma. All right. Clear, Shreya?
Yes, sir.
Let's check out one more question. We'll do the exercises because these are very important. Okay. Next question is this. Have you eliminated some of the options? Those are very clear. Okay, we'll explain it to you. Now here, it's very clear that I have told you in the previous lecture about the usage of both and. That when we are writing the sentence with the word both, we have to use the word and. Both Ram and Shyam. I have given you this example also. Both Ram and Shyam have to go to the market. So obviously both is having a very strong connection with and. So we have to use both these sentences. Okay. So both and should be there in every sentence. First of all, we'll check that. So we'll check that in every sentence, they are using the both and usage. Okay. But the difference is that if we are talking about that unsolicited electronic junk mail, also termed spam. So this is the term referred to this definition. Has hurt companies because they are using the word has to refer spam. Has hurt companies by. So we can't use both word first. First of all, we have to tell through which thing we have it has hurt the companies. So the draining should be written after by, and then we have to use the word both here because we are referring that spam has hurt companies by draining both dash and dash. Okay, something has been drained. We have to tell what are these two things which has drained the companies. All right, or hurt the companies. So the draining should be in the very beginning. So the sentence starting with draining are second and third. Rest, all these will be incorrect. Both draining company and diminishing employee productivity is wrong because draining should become before that. Okay. In the fourth option saying, is saying both draining company resources used to combat the problem and the productivity of employees diminished. They have changed the verb sentence. They have actually not written the parallel structure. Parallel structure was this one. Draining company resources, diminishing employee productivity. We can't change the sentence after and as a whole. So this is perfectly wrong. This is having a different structure. And same in the case of fifth option. It is written how productive its employees are. All right, so this is also a wrong sentence to use. Let's check out that in second and third, which sentence is correct. So they are using unsolicited electronic junk mail, also termed spam, has hurt companies by draining both company resources used to combat the problem and diminishing employee productivity. This is perfectly fine because this is making sense that two things are drained. First, the resources. Second, the employee productivity. All right. So draining refers to resources first and employees' productivity second. But in case of third option, it is written how productive its employees are. Sentence is changed. Verb is changed. So definitely this will not be the answer. So the correct answer will be B option. I hope it is very much clear to you. Shreya, is it clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Let's check out one more question. This is very easy and interesting. A simple one. All these are latest exam questions. So you should definitely have a look at all these questions very carefully because you're going to get the same kind of questions in your exam also if you are preparing for.
Ma'am, the right answer will be I think fourth.
Right answer is fourth. Very good. How did you find it?
Because verb is reducing, relaxing, and regulating the sleep cycle.
Yes. Reducing anxiety is verb's first form plus ing. Relaxing, verb's first form plus ing. In regulating the sleep cycle. Right. So this in word here is a very different word, which is not required in this particular sentence because it's not written in the previous sentences. All right. So they can just simply say and regulating the sleep cycle. So there's no need to use the in word here, which is written in the A option. In the regulation of, they have changed the sentence structure. So the second option is incorrect. Regulation of, regulation is a wrong word to use here. And regulating is perfectly okay. And means of reducing anxiety, relaxing the brain and regulating. Okay, so now here, in the fourth and fifth option, what is the difference? Can you check it and in this particular sentence? Because it is written by here and they are using of, unnecessary, right? So this is a particular difference. Off is not required. All right. So this is a basic difference and you can easily eliminate this option as well because off is not required. Otherwise, we have to use off in this also. That is not an option. Okay. All right. Let's solve another question. This one. Now, this is a tough one, but ultimately it will come to be very easy if you will be able to find the answer, correct answer.
Ma'am, I think third will be the right answer.
Okay, good enough. Now, can you explain this?
Because when the incident is, so he attended, not receiving.
Yes, it is written attended here. It is written receiving here and developing. All right. So it should be, sorry. One second. It is written after moving to Switzerland.
My voice is breaking.
Am I audible now? Hello, am I audible? Hello, am I audible? Okay. So basically, this question says, after moving to Switzerland in 1890s, Albert Einstein attended the Swiss Federal Polytechnic School in Zurich. So he actually had attended it. So C option says the same thing, which you have told us. Receiving is a continuous tense, verb's first form plus ing. That is not required because here it's verb's third form used for Albert Einstein. Sorry, second form, who attended the Swiss Federal Polytechnic School, received in-depth training in quantitative analysis and developed a foundation for his future work in mathematical physics. So everything will be in the second form of verb because subject is used here. So obviously we are talking about the past tense. So it should be verb second form. All right. In the other sentences, they are just having imparallel structures. Attended, receiving, developing, wrong. Attended, receiving, developed, wrong. Attended, received, developing. Developing is wrong here. Attending, receiving, developing is no doubt correct, but they're talking about the past tense. Definitely ing verbs will not be used here. So ultimately the answer will be the C option. Okay. Perfectly okay. Let's solve another question now. This one. Done. Okay, should I have a join?
Yes.
Okay, now solve this question. Okay, shall I tell you now? Or do you have any answer? The question says, while an extensive amount of research into the cause of acoustic neuromas have proven unsuccessful, doctors have developed new surgical options that have dramatically increased patients' survival rates. So in the whole sentence, only the problem is in the underlined sentence. And there should be, because if they are talking about an extensive amount of research, this is singular, right? So basically, if they're talking about the amount of research, an amount of research, so definitely there should be a singular verb. That is has, all right? Because it is referring to the amount of research has proven unsuccessful. So every sentence which is containing have in it will be wrong. Right? So the first question A and the C option is eliminated because there the have word was used. All right. So we'll eliminate it. And rest of the questions, let's check out the B option. The amount of research into the cause of acoustic neuromas has proven unsuccessful. Nothing has changed. The sentence is as it is. So only the has word is changed. So this is perfectly correct. But let's check out the other question, other sentences as well. D says, cause research into acoustic neuromas. Now here, the cause word is replaced and it is written in the beginning. Cause research. So this has is not making sense with the word cause research. Nothing has caused research which has proven unsuccessful. Okay. There should be an extensive amount of research. That's a particular one sentence. We can't change the sentence as a whole. All right. So this is also eliminated. Then comes E option. Amount of research, correct. Has proven unsuccessful, correct. Into the cause of acoustic neuromas. Now again, the sentence has been changed. The structure has been changed. So definitely we can't change it as per our requirement. All right. So it should be in the very beginning, which shows that B is the correct answer here. I hope your answer will also be B. Right. So let's check out one more question. This is again, interesting, easy, but somewhat tricky. So just try to find it out. The answer for this question. Nanshreya? A very interesting question. And the question starts with a contradictory connector, while. This is a complex sentence. While the media should present a neutral view of the news with their aim to stir discussion and unsettle complacent thinkers, right? So this is the sentence. So they are just comparing two structures here. What media should do? Either they should present a neutral view of the news, or they should try aiming on their stir discussion or unsettlement of the complacent thinkers. Now here, if the sentence, we have to make a parallel sentence, we have to use the word should in the next sentence after comma as well. Otherwise, the sentence will be incomplete. All right. If the media should do this thing or this thing. So definitely both need suggestions in this case. So with their aim to stir, it's a wrong sentence. All right. It will also stir. No doubt media is collective noun. So it should be used or it can be used, but ultimately it will also stir. Will is not the correct sentence to use here. They're not talking about the future. They're talking about an obligation, that it is the obligation of the media to present neutral view of the news and to stir discussion, okay, in front of the public. Also, trying to stir. Trying is something which is a continuous tense, which the media is doing right now, but they are just giving a suggestion. So ultimately, we don't know that media is using something or not. So the elements should be parallel here. Now you can see in the D and E option, should is used. So definitely in both these options, the answer will be there. Okay. Now we'll definitely use these two sentences here and we'll check that whether it is making a parallel structure or not. While the media should present a neutral view of the news, it should also try to stir discussion, unsettle complacent thinkers. Yes, it's making sense. Now you will say it, as the media is a collective noun. So definitely it can be referred to media, that it should stir. Okay, clear? So this can be the correct sentence. But in E option, it's saying its goal should also be the stirring of. We are not talking about the goals here. Its goals, we can't change the word as per our requirement. Should also be, also is a wrong sentence to use here. Why? Because we are starting our sentence with while. And while is used in case of comparisons or making complex sentences. So also can't be used here. Also is also a connector. Also is also used in complex sentences. So together two sentences can't be used. All right. So if I'm using while, we'll make a direct sentence here. It should also try to stir. All right. Now here also can be referred to it because the media is used again. All right. But here they are changing the structure of the sentence. The goal should also be. That is wrong. All right. So these are the differences between the D and the E option. That's why the answer will be D, because it refers to media. Its goal is wrong. All right. Is it clear, Shreya?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next question here is, the themes that Rita Dove explores in her poetry is universal, encompassing much of the human condition, while occasionally she deals with racial issues. You have to find the error in this sentence, okay? And find the correct sentence out of it. Just giving you 2 minutes.
Ma'am, there is previous question on screen.
Okay. Is it clear now? Is it there?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Just wait for a second option. Now,
no, ma'am. Previous question.
Okay, I'm just showing you. Just a second. Let me check. Now. Just a second, Shreya. Shreya, is it visible now? Just check it out. Can you see the slide?
Now it is visible, ma'am.
Okay. Got the answer, Shreya? You have to eliminate some of the options. Okay, let me give you a hint in this question. It's very easy. The themes that Rita Dove explores in her poetry is, now you can see they are talking about the themes, which is plural, subject. There are a lot of themes, na? So it should be are, not is. Okay, because they are referring to the themes. So the ultimately, A option is incorrect because it has is. B option is incorrect because of is. C, D, E are the remaining options from where we can find our correct answer. All right. So this is the one elimination I have done. The rest of the elimination, you can tell me, okay, out of these three options, which are most likely the options, or you can say which are the most correct options in this case. You have to select two, all right? And out of those two, we'll find the one answer. Did you find the answer, Shreya? The statement says the themes are universal. That is perfectly fine. While occasionally she deals. Now here, first of all, she is not required. Because ultimately they are using the word while here. And before that, they are using encompassing much of the human condition and dealing with racial issues. Not she is dealing. The themes are dealing with the racial issues. All right. So it should be verbs first form plus ing if it is here. It should be the verb first form of ing in the last option as well. So you can check out that in D and E option, the words dealing are there. But you can see in the C option, it is written deals. Again, that's a wrong parallel structures. So now we will eliminate the A, B, C option, left with D and E option. Now out of these options, one sentence is closely related to the answer. So which answer it will be? It is written encompassing and dealing. And in fifth option, they have changed the structure and written the verbs first form. And here the verbs first form plus ing, sorry, right? So the structure has been changed. That's why the answer will be D. Did you get it, Shreya? How we find the answer? First of all, the main problem of helping verb. Then the next problem is of the verbs. So the problem will always be of adjectives, adverbs, verbs, nouns. All right. And you have to find those nouns that whether it is parallel or not. All right. Let's come to the next question. Okay, do this question. Okay, I'll tell you the answer. Have you found the answer, Shreya? You can see this is a non-essential information. I have told you in this very lecture that when examples are given and where refers to here to Vietnam, right? So this is a non-essential information. Without reading this sentence, you have to find the answer. Because this is not required. If we'll eliminate this sentence, still we can find the answer. So they're talking about the CEO said opening new markets in China, especially in Shanghai and in developing economies of Southeast Asia, and this course of action not making any sense. This "and" word is not making sense, because ultimately here, if we read the whole sentence, it is written such as Vietnam, where the corporation sales revenue has been the most robust over the past 3 years. So this particular line refers to Vietnam. That in Vietnam, such as Vietnam, corporation sales revenue has been robust over the past 3 years. So this is all about Vietnam. We don't have to read that. They're just talking about China. We have to focus on the China market. So opening word here is verbs first form plus ing, singular one. Opening new markets. So definitely, if we'll write the verb, it will also be singular. So here, "and" this course of action, "and" is not making sense. Here also, "and" is not making sense, because this is not connected with Southeast Asia. You can just read it, read the line. The opening markets in China, especially in Shanghai, and in developing economies in Southeast Asia, such as Vietnam. So these such as lines, we don't have to read. "And this course of action," not making sense. "Give the most support." "Give" is used in case of plural verb. So this will be incorrect as well. Now these two will be the answer, which has "gives" in it, right? So how we write the answer? "Give the most support to the long-term vision." "Give the most support to the corporation's long-term vision." It should be corporation's long-term vision, because they are just specifically talking about the new markets opening up. All right. And they are focusing on the Vietnam corporation sales and the developing economies. That's why we have to mention this "their" word, that who is we are referring to this word "there" to whom. It's the corporation's long-term vision. That's why we have to add up this word. All right, that's why E will be the correct answer. Otherwise, "to the long-term vision," "the" is not making sense, because it's not anybody's long-term vision. It's the CEO's long-term vision for his company. All right, so E is the accurate answer. I think this lecture will be beneficial for you in future. So, Shreya, did you get every concept?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now just practice about the parallelism question, right? And then we'll meet tomorrow at the same time from 12 to 2 and we'll discuss another concept of CAT GRE examination. We have completed our self-correction and parallelism. We'll start with a different aspect now. All right?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, bye-bye. Take care.
Bye. Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome.